I'm Dr. Sukli Liu, and I'm here today to start off our Smart VR Cribs video series. Today we're going to go behind the scenes to our lab here at the Clinical Sciences Center at the University of Southern California. Come on in! It actually used to be an occupational therapy faculty practice, which is why we have a reception desk. We've got a lot of fan art given to us by ourselves. We have a painting of a beach scene made by one of our participants who we put in virtual reality in a beach scene, and then he liked it so much that he created his own for us. We hang it here. This is the PhD student's room.
Hi, I'm Julia. I'm a PhD student in neuroscience.
Hi, I'm Octavia. I'm a PhD student in biomedical engineering.
Hi, I'm Miranda. I'm a PhD student in occupational science.
Hi, I'm Chris. I'm a research assistant professor in occupational science and occupational therapy. And here in this lab, I focus on projects related to neurorehabilitation after stroke.
Is a multi-purpose room. It's an experiment room. It also has a plinth so that we could put patients on it, theoretically. This is where we do some meetings.
Hi, I'm Lily. I'm a PhD student in occupational therapy and occupational science.
I'm Laura. I'm an undergrad in computational neuroscience.
So this, for instance, is an apparatus that we built ourselves. Just the box. And this is a tablet, and we give people feedback of visual motor adaptation, either on a screen or in virtual reality. And in here is our main lab. Come on in. We can do a variety of behavioral tests. We can also measure kinematics using these tracking cameras. We have a few lab stations set up, a little tinkering. This is Coralie, the best VR programmer in the world. Alright, and then the other thing is that this lab space is actually pretty large, so we can move this partition.
Our current VR system for giving feedback of muscle activity to stroke survivors.
It can give either brain or muscle activity, and today we're testing out muscle activity with one of our wonderful participants here. It's a 3D printer. This is our OG EEG 3D printed headset. We tried to make it USC colors like cardinal and gold, but it kind of came out like McDonald's. Which I'm not opposed to, actually. Over here is where we do some more behavioral testing so we can test arm motor function. We have a collection of neuroscience holiday artwork. This is our hair washing station. So this is for after we do EEG studies. If you've got electrodes on your head, then we can do the hair wash here. Tend to only wash the part of your hair that touched the electrodes. We'll at least get half of your head.
Alright, now they gave me the camera so that I can show you the most important room of all, our war room. Just kidding, it's the kitchen.
Well, they're very important because many people here can get hangry.
We have three coffee machines that fuel our research. And water today. And our best snacks. Gummy bears. content.
Go.
Ready?
Okay. You know, this is not the filming part. I was just... Monet was just nearsighted. I think I see the future of art, and it is this. And you can take each piece out if you want. Oh.